Okay, then let's move to the next topic is special business transactions. Okay, so we have again two different types of billing in the system if you want to use it. One is called periodic billing, one is called milestone billing. Okay, so what is periodic billing? On the left hand side, if you see periodic billing, so periodic billing is like, it's used mostly in the service department. So when you want to charge the customer periodically, for example, 1st of every month or 15th of every month or anything like that. Okay, for example, rental contract, or you servicing their servers, okay, or you servicing their machinery regularly or monthly or weekly or something like that, and you want to charge them like 1st of every month, last date of every month, like that. That's a periodic billing. That means you're saying, okay, customer will be paying fixed payment to us on, say, 1st of every month. Okay, so $100 this month, next 1st, again 100, 100, 100, like that. Okay, and for example, if you see this one, periodic billing. Okay, so you created an order and then you have the billing plan. Okay, for example, customer is paying, say, this is a rental contract or something, and customer is paying, say, last date of every month. That means on April 30th, they will be paying 100 euro. On, again, last date of May, they again will pay 100. On last May, date of June, same thing, and last date of July, same thing. Okay, so that's your periodic billing. So let me show you. So this is basically used in the scenario of contracts. Okay, when we have the contracts. Okay, so contract is, for example, you created some contract to repair a machinery or something, and you want to charge the customer on periodic basis, then you will be doing using this. Okay, so let me show you one example here. Yes, Manish, you have a question? Yes, you can do that in sales order as well. Okay, so I'll be showing you some customizing, and that's basically item related customizing. You can use it in any item. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. I'll show you in a minute. Okay, let me show you this functionality first. So if I create a contract, so contract is VA41. Or I can go from here to create a contract. Sales and distribution, master data, sales and contract, VA41. So we have different types of contract here. So we have seen it before. So, like quantity contract and billing, and the other one is SC, service and maintenance, for example. Okay, first act SC. Okay, I will be using the same customer and same material here. But the only difference is item category will be different in this case. Cancel that. So you can see it should be item category WBN. See this one, item category is WBN. Okay, if I select the line item and if I click on billing plan, see this one, billing plan. If I click on billing plan, it will show me the billing plan. See, this is a billing plan. That's billing plan is saying that the customer should be paying the last date of every month. So this is already set up in customizing. That 31st of 7th, 31st of 8th, 30th of 9th, last date of every month, customer will be paying the whatever the price I have set up in the system. Okay, if I scroll down, you will see the same thing like that. Okay, so it's starting today, ending is for 1 year and ending the July next year. Or I can extend it. I can say, okay, I want to this one for 2 years. Five, that's it, done. Okay, and system will all automatically generate the items for that. Okay, so this is your periodic billing. What is 11 here? Where is 11? Oh, this one. This is coming from customizing. I'll show you this one in a minute. Last of every month. Okay, I'll show you in a minute. Okay. So this is basically done because of the item category. Okay, so let me show you this setup. So if I open the item category, sales and distribution, sales item category. So it was WVN. So search WVN, select that details. So if I scroll down, see billing plan type. Okay, billing plan type is 02. Okay, if I open, what is 02? So 02 should be saying I'm periodic billing. See, I'm periodic billing. Okay, so let me check what is periodic billing. Okay, so if you leave it blank, it will behave like a normal item, like a 10 or something. Okay, like in the standard sales order. So if you want to do the same setup in sales order, in 10 item category, assign a billing plan type. For example, 02, or you can create your own as well. Okay, so let me show you the billing this one plan. If I search for billing plan, billing plans like that, open that. So define billing plans. Here you can define it. If I open this one, maintain billing plan for periodic or milestone. Okay, so I'll come back to milestone in a minute. They are the same setting, not much difference. If I double click on periodic billing, here you can see all the periodic billing that is set up in the system. So 02. So we're using 02. If I select 02, either I can copy it and make my own changes. Okay, or if I go to the details, here you can see different setup. For example, start date. What should be the start date? Start date of should be the same as a contract start date. Okay, like for any contract, when I'm creating a contract, for all the contract there's a start date and end date. So system will select this start date as the billing start date and this end date as a billing end date. So this is what the setting is saying. So it's saying start date is 0. That means contract start date, end date is 09. That means contract end date. If I open this one, there must be some other setup as well. Today's date, contract start date, acceptance date, like that. Okay, but in the standard contract, we use contract start date, contract end date. Okay, horizon. Horizon is 10. Okay, 10, today's date plus 1 year. So if I open this one, it's like a determination rule for the dates. Okay, so what that means is that it will be, it will go for next 1 year. This plan will go for, just give me a second. Let me press F1 on this one. Let me make sure what this horizon is. Okay, so it will decide that how long that term will go. Okay, for example, it will say 10 means today's date plus 1 year. This contract is for 1 year. So by default, it will create 1 year entries, like one for every month, 12 entries. Okay, that's what 10 is. Okay, in horizon, how long the plan should go. So even if I open this one, you can see, double click on, sorry, yeah, that's the one. Okay, you can see it's ending on the next year, exactly after 1 month, 1 year. Okay, so today is July, so it's ending on June, exactly after 1 year. So that's coming from the this horizon. Even you can change the horizon from here, from the contract order. Okay, and then next one is 11, next billing date. When should be the next billing date? That is 11. So let's see what is 11. So 11 is last of month for billing date plus 1 month. That means system should always bill, always create the billing document on the last date of every month. Okay, that's why it's saying, because it's 11 here, that's why system is picking up automatically last date of every month. Okay, just because of this horizon. Okay, so that's your periodic plan, periodic billing. Okay, and the other one is also similar. If I show you the other one,